Hello, I am Bishop Earl Boyea of the Diocese of Lansing. For the second half of the Easter season through Wednesday after Pentecost, we will be reading the Acts of the Apostles by St. Luke. In the Acts of the Apostles, Luke continues his work of providing a certainty about the teachings in which Theophilus had been instructed. How can Christianity be the fulfillment of the promises to Israel if the Jewish people do not see Jesus as the Messiah? And how can Gentiles instead claim to be the heirs of those divine promises? Luke's response is that this is God's plan. Thus, Jesus told the apostles that repentance for the forgiveness of sins would be preached in his name to all the nations, beginning in Jerusalem. Jesus adds, "You will be my witnesses in Jerusalem, throughout Judea and Samaria, and to the ends of the earth." Luke presents the account of how God has willed this progress, always under the guidance of the Holy Spirit, to take place. The ministry does begin in Jerusalem with Pentecost and a large number of Jewish adherents, then is expanded to the Greek-speaking Jews throughout the work of the deacons, Stephen and Philip. Two critical elements in God's plan are then manifest in the conversion of St. Paul and Peter's eventual baptism of the Gentile Cornelius. Clearly, it is God's will that Jesus be seen as the Savior of the whole world. The bulk of the Acts are then focused on the ministry of St. Paul, who reaches even into Greece at the direction of the Holy Spirit. The book concludes with a series of trials and defenses of this new ministry in Palestine, Caesarea, and finally in Rome. God has worked in Jesus Christ and his church to bring salvation to the world. What is most fascinating about this book is that it is called the Acts of the Apostles, but the ministries of most of the apostles are not even mentioned. Luke's aim is a singular one, to show that it is God's will that the promises to Abraham be shared with all. Everything else is really secondary. Peter summed this up the best when he went to the Gentile Cornelius. "In truth, I see that God shows no partiality. Rather, in every nation, whoever fears him and accepts uprightly is acceptable to him." After Peter then explained the good news about Jesus, the Holy Spirit came upon Cornelius and his family. Peter noted, "Can anyone withhold the water for baptizing these people who have received the Holy Spirit even as we have?" We are living in the time of the church blessed by the presence of Jesus Christ through his Holy Spirit. God's will applies to us as well. Let us go to the ends of the earth, including our own neighborhoods, to announce the gospel of the Lord.